Praise the Lord. You are kindly be seated. You know, I believe that you have heard yesterday's message that I shared online. Yeah, today I'll share about prayer. You know, I told you last time that prayer is a powerful weapon that God has given His children. Just check your voice, please. We all must pray. Amen. We must not worry but pray. When you pray, you will have the peace of God. You will be surrounded with peace. You know, your words are very powerful. Because your words are with authority. But we must know how to pray. Because we are in the time of grace. Amen. I know many Christians pray, but they don't pray with authority. They pray as a servant. So their prayers are always like pleading and begging. That's the old covenant kind of prayer. We are living in the now time. That is grace time, not in the then time, that is law time. The Bible must be divided rightly between the law time and the grace time. Amen. So that is very important. If you don't know these basics, then even if you may read the Bible, but you may not benefit. Amen. It's not just reading anything from the Bible. No. You must read it in such a way that you see wearing the lens of grace. Because Jesus came as grace after fulfilling the law. Amen. We are not here to fulfill the law. We cannot do it because our flesh is weak. So Jesus fulfilled it and He brought grace. Amen. So living under the time of grace and taking the scriptures that way actually plays a very important role in your life. Prayer which meets the requirement outlined in God's word will always be answered. God is not deaf. In fact, He waits to hear your prayer. It's not that keep on banging and banging that God hears. No. No. The moment you just open your mouth and Father, you say, He is there. Amen. You know, you need to pray with the right information. So prayer becomes powerful when it is coupled with the right understanding of God's word. Pray to God as our Father, not as a judge. Amen. Pray in such a way that He knows what you're going to pray. See, these are the things you need to take it with you when you pray. Amen. So you must have the right knowledge when you pray. If you don't take these things with you, then you will be frustrated. Even while praying, you will become anxious. You will have doubt and unbelief. The word gives you faith. The right word. So equip yourself with the right information and pray. It becomes powerful. Amen. If you come with the thought, I don't know whether God hears my prayer, please Lord, please. See, you'll be frustrated. People think it is an effort because of which God hears. So they try to put in the best effort, the best performance, so that God is moved to answer your prayer. That is why so many Christians don't pray. See, if prayer becomes laborious, it becomes a labor, then people won't pray. Amen. When prayer becomes works, then you will not pray. When you know prayer is just talking to Him, knowing that He has already answered all my prayers. How do we know He answered our prayers? He says, before you ask, believe. You have received. Amen. When Jesus finished His work, that's the answer. The answer comes from the finished works of Jesus. So your mentality should be, He has answered my prayer. Now what is He waiting for? Not your works. You are believing. Amen. When I always tell you this, when it is grace, you need to believe. You don't have to work. Amen. When it is law, you have to work. Get this very clear. When it is law, there is nothing to believe. It has to be worked. It has to be obeyed. Amen. When it is law, you have to work to obey. When it is grace, it is just believe, not work, because He worked it to bring grace, so that you freely receive by faith. Did you understand this? I know for law people it will take much time to understand, because they are not so free to accept it, so that their mind becomes free. You know, these things cloud their understanding. It hinders them, because they have heard so many messages of law that they don't understand grace. You know, I have seen Christians going even through suffering and sickness and disease, but they don't let go of that law. Even if they don't work it out, their mentality is of works, a slave mentality. The more you work, you're developing a slave mentality. Amen. And automatically, you work as slaves. You know, the slaves, in those times they were slaves, they had built up that mentality. They identified themselves as slaves. So automatically they would work. Even if no one tells them, they'll work. Because they identified themselves as slaves. That's what the law does. It puts you in bondage with fear of punishment. Amen. But Christ came to make you free. Amen. So grace gives you freedom. Never bondage. So understand this. Now it's time that Christian, the body of Christ, must understand this. Otherwise, you'll not be able to enter into all that God has for this now time. Amen. It should not take much time now. I told you this, the period, accelerated period of time. Now God is not going to wait for you to understand. Amen. It's high time that we understand now. You know, I told you last time, how many years these Jews took to understand. They didn't understand. Even in the new covenant, Jesus was still preaching, teaching to the Jews. Even he told the disciples, go and teach the Jews. Not to the Gentiles. The time has not come there. But they kept on rejecting. Not understanding God's plan and purpose. Not understanding his time. God didn't have all the time forever and ever. No, for us. Then he closed it. Amen. He blinded their eyes. Temporarily. Now, tumko sidetrack karta. In the meantime, he raised up Paul. Amen. He said, I am turning to the Gentiles. Amen. So don't think God will continue with the church. Now they are not believing in grace. They are not. Nay. It's time of the believe in grace. So when you come to pray, have this mindset. He knows what you're going to pray. Don't come with this thought now. Now he doesn't know. Now I have to make him to understand.
See,
it's not just praying. Equipping yourself with the word and praying. Equipping yourself the right knowledge and praying. The basic thought is we have to pray. But many don't know that you have to equip yourself with the word and then your prayer becomes powerful. Come with this thought. The one I'm coming to pray loves me. Amen. He loves me. They don't come with the kya manam prabhu sunta kya gussa mein aata. See, these kind of thoughts people come with prayer and they pray for hours and 10 hours and 12 hours, it won't work. It won't work. Because you don't have the mentality that he loves you. He's more interested in you than you yourself, interested in your own self. Amen. You don't come with this attitude. My prayer ne kya na Prabhu name. Khush hoega. He won't love me. He won't bless me. He won't heal. Don't come with that mentality. Don't come as doing religious duty. Don't come with that mentality. Come because you have a relationship with God. Even if we don't come, he's not angry. But he loves to have fellowship with you. Amen. More than you're asking for your needs to be met, no, your needs are met.
Amen.
And you will spend much of your time thanking and praising God. Oh, you're great, you're awesome, you're so good, you love me, I thank you.
See,
that is believing. Your prayer is already answered. That's what the Lord said. Believe, you receive them and you have them. So when you speak like this in faith, you're actually saying that God has answered my prayers. Instead of coming that after I put 1 hour, then God will hear. See, these are all law kind of thoughts. Then you will go by works, looking at the time. तुम्हारा फिकर टाइम पे कि प्रभु ऐसा ही सुनेगा ऐसा नहीं, एक घंटा बीत गया है तो हाँ अभी सुना. दिस अ रॉन्ग
मेंटालिटी.
Amen. There is a right way and there is a wrong way to pray. And I told you last time, if you pray the wrong way, even the devil can interfere. I know people will be shocked to hear this, because they think, how can devil interfere when I am praying, I am talking to God? See, from your mouth, either is left life or death. You choose. So, your word should be right. Amen. You don't open the door for the devil. By the words that you speak, you open the door for the devil. Or you open the door for God. Amen. So these things you need to know. I gave all these messages before. So let me go to this, you know. This I was just giving you some introduction, but it will take a long time. Because more than prayer, you need to know how to pray. With the right information, the right mentality. Okay, I'll teach you about that, because that's very important. You need to be equipped well with the word knowledge so that you come to pray in a right way. Now now we must pray daily. If you're a saint, you must be praying daily. Let me tell the youth. Then I'll address those who are married. If you're not married yet, know this. Your marriage doesn't work because of your great love for one another. You need God. You need fellowship. Not only with one another, but also with God. You must pray. So choose a partner who is going to pray with you. Amen. Don't go only by the flesh. You know, believers go only external. Flesh ka desire external rehta. Main kala hu gori. This is the thought of man. Handsome woman. That is the world's thought. Your thought is different. Amen. No one thing. I have to pray with my wife or with my husband daily. Amen. Yehi mat dekho. Paisa wala hai. Woh naam hai. That is the flesh that wants all this. Put spirituality first. I'm not saying कोई भी किसको भी ढूंढो अंधाल लो, ऐसा नहीं बोल रहा हूँ. प्रायोरिटी स्पिरिचुअल रखो, उसके बाद तुम्हारा डिजायर रखो. Amen. But know one thing, we are going to pray after getting married. Amen. That's the first thing I told my wife. 29 years ago, I told my wife, we are going to pray daily. As husband and wife. Amen. And second, we are not going to miss church. Amen. इसके लिए हम लोग शुरुआत में किधर नहीं गए क्योंकि मीटिंग था इसके लिए आने का था. See, God sees your heart. He remembers.
वो याद रखता है.
If you have given priority to spirituality, He remembers. Based on that, He moves in your life.
और उसी गुरु के आधार पे वो आपके जीवन में काम करता है.
He knows you inside out.
वो अंदर बाहर से आपको जानता है.
What you choose, what decisions you take, how you put spirituality, you give priority to spirituality. He is watching you. He knows you. Whether people know you or not. Even if you hide in the closet, He sees you. He knows your mind. The devil cannot read your mind. Hello? But the magicians do all this, but I'll tell you later on all those things. But the devil cannot read your mind. You know, never go to these people, magicians, you know, who will tell you, see, now I can read your mind. Don't go to them. Don't attend to them. This is out of the way, but I'm telling you this. Because there's a way the devil works. You know, the devil will put thoughts for you to think. And that man knows the thoughts that he has put by the devil's power. And you tell them, "Oh, the book is a man." So these are all demonic things. Never go to all this. Many Christians don't know. They think this is fun. The devil puts that name fun, and that fun he destroys. You know, many times I love to see some fun movies.
Because
Holy Spirit told me that good humor is good. But there is a bad humor. So there are some good things, there are bad things. But I have seen 99% of the movies. In the beginning they'll show good. Then starts with violence. Oh man, it's the worst violence. You take this all and deposit in your soul, in your heart. This eye is the gate to receive. Your mouth is the gate to receive. Your ear is the gate to receive. Amen. These are the gates to receive, to deposit things that should not be deposited in your heart. Amen. Very dangerous. Even if you pray, it doesn't go out. First, you must identify yourself for who you are. Then you must remove it. Amen. God won't stop that. He has given you a choice. Amen. Don't think, Prabhu, tu sab dikh. Aisa nahi. Tumne choose kiya hai, tum hi nikalo. So that's why you need to know how to pray under the new covenant of grace. So I told my wife, we are going to pray daily. And we have been praying. There are families who came and said, Pastor, मैं हमेशा wife बोलता पढ़ो पढ़ो पढ़ो. वो बोलती नहीं अभी नहीं बाद में ऐसे. वो बोलते क्या मैं ही बार बार बोलने का तू क्यों नहीं. I don't know why this superiority or inferiority comes. This attitude should come.
प्रार्थना की बात आ रही है मुझे पता नहीं लगता है कि क्यों मैं पहले तू पहले ऐसे क्यों होना चाहिए.
You know, don't get married if you're not going to pray. Because you don't need to get married to go to heaven. In fact, Apostle Paul said, I'm freeing you from all the troubles that marriage has. But if you have the gift of singleness, remain single. If you have the gift of marriage, go ahead and get married. But you know, the society will be, what is the shadi mein kya? What's the problem? You're not living for the samaj. Our life, we are living based on the knowledge of God's word. We are not here to please the samaj. We are here to please God. Amen. So, if you think of getting married, ask the partner, are we going to pray daily? Because prayer nahi hai, to nuksan hi nuksan hai. Tumhara aage ka parivar ke liye nuksan hai, bachche logon ke liye nuksan hai. If you are fighting at home, there are eyes watching you. Six aankhein rahega, teen log rahega to. They are watching you. And the worst thing is you are storing the negative things in their soul. Sir, baat se kapda deke khana khila ke sab theek nahi hota hai. What you are storing in the negatives, they are going to live by the negatives because it's going to control their life. I didn't know all these things. I was just new in the Lord. And before that I was not in the Lord. What went into my soul that time, I know how difficult it is to come out. I used to have bad dreams. Tormenting dreams. Of the images that I have seen that time. The words that have been spoken before me when I was a child. For so many years. Later when the Holy Spirit taught me how to remove all this. It stopped. Amen. So there are many things to learn. If you don't learn all these things, you'll not be able to do it for yourself. You know, when a child goes out, there'll be others who will be bullying them, teasing them, mocking them. What are you going to do? Hey, मेरे पास बहुत पैसा है, मेरे पास बहुत नाम है, उसमें कुछ काम नहीं आता. नाम रह के पैसा रह के भी लोग मर जाते हैं. It doesn't help them. Amen. You must pray. For your family. Husband, wife first. Children. All those who are at home. Then your circle. Everyone has a circle around you. You are responsible. You are the light person. God will not ask the dark person to pray for them. You must pray. If every child of God does that, God's kingdom will go forward so quickly. And the devil has to move out. Amen. If you take up the responsibility, don't think someone else will pray. You have to pray. You know, the problem is many have been hearing that Amara Pratna Prabhu ne sunta hai. Iske liye tum log pratna bhi karte ho, और उसमें भी ताकत नहीं है, और थोड़े लोग नहीं भी करते क्योंकि उन लोग लगता है मेरा प्रार्थना क्या प्रभु सुनेगा. सी बिकॉज ऑफ द रॉन्ग इन्फॉर्मेशन यू आर हियरिंग. ओ मैन, द इंट्रोडक्शन ओनली फिनिशेज आवर टाइम. You know, because these things are very important. If you don't have these basics, the foundation, you are building your life without a foundation. It won't stand. What is the use of teaching about prayer when you don't have the basic foundation? Amen. Many preachers are preaching. बस प्रे घंटा घंटा प्रेयर करो, प्लीट करके प्रेयर करो. वो जो विधवा औरत कैसा उसने बार बार मांगी, वो सब बार बार मांगो. जो इट दे आर शोइंग प्रेयर इज एन सेल्फ एफर्ट. तो इसके लिए वो ताकत से लोग उन लोगों ने जितना ज्यादा ताकत लगाया ना उतना प्रभु सुनने वाला. Are you seeing this? सेल्फ का ताकत, एफर्ट लगाने का, खिड़खिड़ाने का, रोने का, ब्रेथ को मार के लेने का, प्रभु ताकत. See, this is not the way at all. That is why I am teaching you this basics. You know, lastly, you know, we'll not go now much there. You know, before you read the Bible, it's better that you understand the timeline and the basic foundation. जब तक basics तुमको मालूम नहीं है, तुम क्या लेने का क्या नहीं लेने का तुमको मालूम भी नहीं रहेगा. कुछ भी लेगा बाइबल से. First get the basics right. Amen. And prayer is a powerful weapon. If you are not praying, there are suddenlies in life. Amen. That's a sad thing. Now, I spoke about those who are not married. Those who are married, if you have not started to pray, you must pray daily with one another and pray for your family. You are responsible. Amen. You are the closest. God has loaned your children to you. Now, I don't want to say your child. Holy Spirit told me He has loaned His child to you. Think that way. This is God's child. Loaned to me. Given to me. Under my responsibility. Amen. So don't ill-treat them. No. He loves them. You pray for your child. First husband, wife must pray. Pray for your children. Pray for your family. Secondly, take care of your words. Don't think, you know, Christian ka thought kaisa hai, the worldly thought. Usne kuch bola, mai bhi usko 10 bolne ka. Holy Spirit told me, even if someone offends you, if you take that offense, you are worse than the one who offends you. Hello? What comes out of your mouth, if it is negative or positive, how does it work? Why does it work? Because it enters your heart. Amen. Now, you confess the word. Don't think confess the word means vachan bahar ja raha hai. Vachan tumhare andar aa raha hai. Amen. इसके पहले बाहर जाता हुआ वचन अंदर आता है, इट ग्रोज इन यू,
वो आपके अंदर बढ़ता है.
See, these are the basics you must know. So don't think, उसको ना मैं अच्छा गाली देके आया, मैं बहुत बड़ा काम नहीं किया, वो गाली तुम्हारे में गया. हेलो, the worldly thought is, उसको ऐसा दो तीन बजाया ना जबान से, वो हैरान हो गया, डर गया, ऐसा बोला मैंने नहीं, वो बोला तुम जो उसके लिए वो तुम्हारे लिए आया है. Did you understand this? You are going to live by that. What you have said will influence your life. It will show effect in you first. It will manifest in your life and through your life first. A time will come. You won't be controlling those thoughts. Or those words you have spoken will control you. इसलिए तुम लोग बोलते रहोगे, नहीं मैं ऐसा नहीं बोला, तो मैं कैसा ऐसा बोला? I didn't know, I don't want to say this, but I don't. You didn't want to say it. Then how did it happen? You have been storing these things. Hello, there are so many things I would want to tell you. But now we don't have time. Okay, praise God. Yes. There are many on. Yeah, you're watching me. Praise God. Good. Then it's some of them here. Then close.